praises to our God. Every word of worship with one accord. Every praise is to our God. Every praise is to our God. Every word of worship with one accord. Every praise is to our God.
Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Good morning. Welcome to worship at St. Stephen Lutheran Church. This morning we gather to hear the word of God, to share in the Lord's Supper, and to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed. Today is the fourth Sunday of Easter, and our continued celebration of the resurrection focuses today on this essential promise. In the waters of baptism, we receive the gift of new life, eternal life, through the risen Christ. We live eternally in the care of our good shepherd, to dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let us begin our worship with a moment of silence, an opportunity to center ourselves in the presence of our living Lord. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. In the waters of baptism, we have passed over from death to life with Jesus Christ, and we are a new creation. For this saving mystery and for this water, let us bless God, who was, who is, and who is to come. We thank you, God, for your river of life flowing freely from your throne, through the earth, through the city, through every living thing. You rescued Noah and his family from the flood. You opened wide the sea for the Israelites. Now in these waters you flood us with mercy, and our sin is drowned forever. You open the gate of righteousness, and we pass safely through. In Jesus Christ, you calm and trouble the waters. You nourish us and enclose us in safety. You call us forth and send us out. In lush and barren places, you are with us. You have become our salvation. Now breathe upon this water and awaken your church once more. Claim us again as your beloved and holy people. Quench our thirst, cleanse our hearts, wipe away every tear. To you, our beginning and our end, our shepherd and lamb, be honor, glory, praise, and thanksgiving, now and forever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God of peace, you brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of your eternal covenant. Make us complete in everything good, that we may do your will and work among us all that is well-pleasing in your sight. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading is Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The Lord makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters. You restore my soul, O Lord, and guide me along right pathways for your name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup is running over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. A reading from Revelation. After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, "Amen, blessed and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these, robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated in the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." Word of God, word of life.
The Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. At that time, the festival of the dedication took place in Jerusalem. It was winter, and Jesus was walking in the temple in the portico of Solomon. So the Jews gathered around him and said to him, "How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Messiah, tell us plainly." Jesus answered, "I have told you, and you do not believe. The works that I do in my Father's name testify to me, but you do not believe because you do not belong to my sheep. My sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. What my Father has given me is greater than all else, and no one can snatch it out of the Father's hand. The Father and I are one." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For some of us, these words are still pretty new. The imagery of a shepherd, less familiar, perhaps even archaic. But for others, those lyrical phrases of Psalm 23 are deeply known, often repeated in prayer or at funerals, so that they have worn soft grooves into our hearts. The wonderful thing about the scriptures is that they are a living word. And whether the words are new to us or deeply familiar, through them, the Holy Spirit is always speaking and ready to offer us something new for our lives. For example, a preacher friend pointed out to me something in Psalm 23 that helped me to hear it and appreciate it in a new way. It has to do with that last line of the psalm, which says, "Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life." I find that such a comforting promise, one that usually strikes me as gentle, peaceful, reassuring. But this friend pointed out to me that the word translated into English as follow can mean other things too. It might also mean pursue, chase, put to flight, or simply seek. Which means that that last line of the psalm might just as easily be translated, "Surely goodness and mercy shall chase after me. It shall pursue me, shall seek after me all the days of my life." Paying attention to that kind of a detail brings a new sense to something that is so familiar. Because words like pursue and chase have an entirely different energy, far more energetic than simply follow. They seem less gentle and almost aggressive. Pursuit, that's a word that we would usually use with adversaries more than with a loving God. It's enemies that chase us down or the ghosts of mistakes that we have made long ago. We're pursued by prowling wolves, things like debt or cancer or depression. These things are the ones that seek to snatch and scatter us from the safety and shelter of the sheepfold. But picture this. It is not just wolves and enemies that pursue us. God pursues us as well, chasing us down out of a passionate desire for us to know the truth of our lives, that we are precious and beloved children of God. God pursues us. The one who formed us in the womb, the one who knows us inside and out, this one does not wish any in the sheep to be lost or scattered. It's why our good shepherd lays down his life for us, so that nothing in all of creation, not even death itself, will ever be able to separate us from God's love. Goodness and mercy, they pursue us. No matter which valleys we fall into, and no matter when we have convinced ourselves that we're on our own or that maybe no one is listening to our prayers. But what does it look like that God pursues us? Well, let's rewind a bit earlier in the Gospel of John to John chapter 9, where Jesus meets a man at the temple. Now, we don't know the man's name, only that he was born blind. He knew the darkness of the valley. He had experienced darkness not just in his eyes, but the darkness in his life of being cast out by his community. You see, from his earliest days, he'd been chased down by the question, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? His neighbors assumed that someone had to be to blame for his suffering. Maybe he was to blame for it. And so he was left on his own to beg at the temple, surrounded by strange people and strange sounds, and filled with a fear of not knowing what is happening around him. But then came Jesus. And Jesus spread mud on his eyes and told him to go and wash. And when the man did all of this, he was able to see. With joy, he looked around the world for the first time. He finally saw the faces of his parents and the magnificent temple where he had spent so many of his days. The momentousness of what he experienced filled him with awe and with wonder. Yet being healed brought new problems and controversy. As he shared his testimony and insisted that Jesus was sent by God, the leaders cast him out of the synagogue. But even then, God's goodness and mercy pursued the man who had been born blind but was blind no longer. Jesus went looking for him. The man worshiped Jesus, confident that Jesus was much more than just a prophet. He must be the Son of God. And that man lived the rest of his days as a follower of Jesus. It's these events, it's this story that provide the context in which Jesus calls himself the Good Shepherd in John chapter 10. Jesus, the Good Shepherd, didn't see this man simply as a sinner to be cast out or blamed for his own suffering. Jesus saw one of his own sheep, one who had heard his voice and believed in him, only to be separated from the flock of God by the callous judgment of others. So Jesus chased this man down with love, chased him with healing and with welcome, and restored him to where he belonged, safely within the flock. This one healing was a sign of the greater work of Jesus to restore and save the whole world. He didn't come into the world to condemn and divide it, but to proclaim and embody the goodness and mercy of God. The same goodness and mercy pursue us still today, with the promise and the assurance that we are never, ever alone. And yet there are times when our fear or despair can blind us. There are seasons when our hearts are too heavy with grief for us to look up, to look around, to seek the goodness that is already there. Some time ago, I paid a visit to a woman who had just lost her husband. She was doing her best. She was bearing up in kind of a typical Midwestern fashion, trying to look strong as she navigated all of those strange new things like living alone. But even so, it was clear to me as her pastor that she was struggling. God's goodness and mercy did not feel near to her. During our visit, we shared communion. And as I handed her bread and proclaimed that promise that this is the body of Christ given for you, she spoke a quiet thank you. And tears filled her eyes, and she wept silently. After we'd finished praying together, she said to me, "God must have known how much I needed you today." Through a visit with her pastor, her church had shown up for this widow. She felt less alone in those prayers and in that moment. We shared a meal and we got to share that sense of belonging together. We were part of one flock, and our Good Shepherd was present with us in that valley, in that shadow, in that grief. And that's the promise that we hear today for ourselves. The Lord pursues you in the dark valley, or when you struggle to hear that trustworthy voice. When you feel most isolated, he pursues, rod and staff in hand, so that you will never be snatched out of his hand. Through water and the word, in your baptism, God has pursued you with goodness and mercy and united you with Christ. You have been joined into Christ's death and resurrection. And so that you may live in newness of life, and you belong forever to the Good Shepherd, to his flock. Now together we are being sent out in love and service in thanksgiving for all that we have received. The church, we are the visible body of Christ in the world, and through the church, God continues to pursue all of God's children. God's goodness and mercy are still being poured out into the world. And it happens in small ways, in daily moments, all the time, through us. That time when you decided to mend an old hurt by seeking someone's forgiveness, God was pursuing you with mercy. And that day when you met someone who struggled, you recognized from experience, God's goodness was pouring out as you spoke those essential words, "Me too." When you visited with someone who was struggling in their loneliness, it was God's goodness and mercy pursuing them through you. Goodness and mercy chase after those living in homelessness when you treat them with dignity and when you advocate for their needs. Goodness and mercy follow hungry kids when you support the backpack food program with your time and your offerings. All of this happens through sheep like us, through a community that bears Christ's name into the world and faithfully obeys his commandment to love one another. God's goodness and mercy are being poured out into the world so that all of God's children can see and hear and know the voice of their good shepherd, the one to whom they belong today and forever. And surely God's goodness and mercy shall pursue us and chase after us and seek us all the days of our lives.
Thank you.
Let us profess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Set free from captivity to sin and death, we pray to the God of resurrection for the church, people in need, and for all creation. Gentle Shepherd, enable your church to respond to the voice of Jesus. Give us unfailing trust, unafraid to join in Jesus' work of renewing all things. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Feed your people at the table of creation. Prepare a safe place for those whose environments are dangerous or unhealthy, especially those making difficult journeys. Prosper your creation for the sake of every living thing. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Warm the hearts of all who celebrate and all who mourn on Mother's Day. Accompany those yearning to be mothers. Help us to heal from broken family relationships and open us to receive your nurturing love from all who serve mothering roles in our lives. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Inspire the words of prophets and saints who employ innovative imagery or stretch our understanding. Send Christ to instruct us with motherly care. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Be present with all those impacted by the war Russia is waging against Ukraine. Protect innocent civilians against attacks. Be with those who mourn the loss of life. We cry out to you for an end to this hostility. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all those things which we have gratitude and are thankful. Let us take a moment to type our gratitudes in the comments section. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all those things for which we have concerns and weigh heavily upon us. Let's take a moment to type our concerns in the comments section. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Seek out those who weep while they await healing or consolation. Set people in their path who can provide the care they need and wipe away every tear from their eyes. We pray by name for Brianna, Elizabeth and Jada, Jerry, Shelley, Royce and Jean, Ethan, Randy, Keith, and Dan, as well as all those listed in the prayer list, typed in the comments section, and remembered in our hearts. Continue to comfort and give them strength during their time of illness. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Enfold us in the great multitude of saints from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages. We pray by name for Darlene Meyer, Todd Loggie, Lori Kittleson, Kathy Klipfel. Wash us in your saving grace every day, guiding us to your waters of life. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In your mercy, O God, respond to these prayers and renew us by your life-giving Spirit through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. As our musicians offer their musical gifts, please take a moment to make an offering of your own. If you would like to make a financial offering in support of God's ministries here at St. Stephen Lutheran Church, that gift can be made online or by mailing it to the church office. We also invite you to make an offering of your life, to consider how you will live out your love for God and for your neighbor in your daily ministry as a disciple of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Living God, you gather the wolf and the lamb to feed together in your peaceful reign, and you welcome us all at your table. Reach out to us through this meal and show us your wounded and risen body, that we may be nourished and believe in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. it is right to give our thanks and praise. Holy, living, and loving God, we praise you for creating the heavens and the earth. We bless you for bringing Noah and his family through the waters of the flood, for freeing your people Israel from the bonds of slavery, and for sending your Son to be our Redeemer. We give you thanks for Jesus, who, living among us, healed the sick, fed the hungry, and with a love stronger than death, gave his life for others. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his life-giving death and glorious resurrection, we await your promised life for all this dying world. Breathe your Spirit on us and on this bread and cup. Carry us in your arms from death to life, that we may live as your chosen ones, clothed in the righteousness of Christ. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit and your Holy Church, both now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. As you take the bread and wine that you have prepared at home, hear this promise that the risen Christ dwells with us here. All who are hungry, all who are thirsty, come. The body of Christ given for you, take and eat. The blood of Christ shed for you, take and drink.
We all start on the outside. Outside looking in, this is where grace begins. We were hungry, we were thirsty, with nothing left to give, or the shape that we were in. Just when all hope seemed lost, love opened the sit down and be set free.
to the young and to the older, all who hunger, all who thirst, all the last and all the first, all the paupers and the princes, all who failed, you've been forgiven, all who dream and all who suffer, all who loved and lost another, all the chained and all the free, all who follow, all who lead, anyone who's been let down, all the lost you have been found, all who play both right or wrong, to everyone who hears this song.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen and keep you in God's grace. Amen. Let us pray. We give you thanks, generous God, for in this bread and cup we have tasted the new heaven and earth where hunger and thirst are no more. Send us from this table as witnesses to the resurrection, that inspired by the gifts of baptism, we may live among God's faithful people, hear the word of God and share in the Lord's Supper, proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, serve all people following the example of Jesus, and strive for justice and peace in all the world. Amen. As we are sent from this service into the service of our lives, a few invitations. First, the invitation to financially support our Backpack Buddies ministry. This ministry will continue to the end of the school year, helping Urbandale school students. We are running low on the funds that are needed to purchase the particular items in their ready-to-eat meals, so we appreciate any special offerings that you might share in order to help us complete this year and this ministry. Also, an invitation to help us in our search for a new communications manager. We have decided to extend the deadline a few more weeks to seek additional candidates. You can help by sharing the information about the position with any family and friends that you might have who have skills in written communications, websites, or video. The details about the position are all posted on the church website. You can also find some basic details in the Friday emails. The new application deadline is Monday, May 16th. So thank you for your help with this. Receive this blessing. God, the author of life, Christ, the living cornerstone, and the life-giving spirit of adoption, bless you now and forever. Amen.
Journey to believe, hearts are burning.
Alleluia, Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Go in peace, tell what God has done. Thanks be to God. And let all God's people say, Amen.